Hey, what is up guys? PK here, and in today's video I want to do three things. Firstly, I'm going to cover the entire crafting system of Vermintide, how it works, how you use it, what it's good for. Secondly, I want to talk about drop rates. So essentially, what are the estimated drop rates for veteran items across different qualities of chests? And thirdly, I want to explain in detail how you can use these mechanics and knowledge of these mechanics to get to 300 item power as quickly as possible.
What do we do now? What do you mean? Now we can finally play the game. Oh yeah!
Now, briefly, before we get started, two things. First of all, there will be an update on the viewer event coming either tomorrow or the day after. And secondly, I just have to whine a little bit about how naive I am and how difficult this video actually was to make. It's like this is one of those videos where PK goes, "I'll make a video about the crafting system, right? Because I already know how the crafting system works. Then I can talk a little bit about the drop rates of chests, because I already have a pretty good idea of what the drop rates are. And you know, then I can explain to people how to get 300 power as quickly as possible. Easy, right?" Until I decided to, it's like, just in case. I know how this works, but just in case, I'll look it up, right? And then you go from like one Reddit post to another, from one article to another, from one forum post to another, and like at a certain point you start to question yourself, right? Because they all say conflicting things. Some of it is just flat out wrong. Others say stuff that was probably right in the patch it was set in, and like you're trying to piece together this puzzle. And at a certain point, I was like, screw this, I'm starting a new Vermintide account. So I have to family share my game again, start from scratch again, just to double check that what I was saying was actually accurate. Then grind a bunch of items, then actually record from start to finish as I got up to 220, 30 power-ish, right? So from 5 item power to 230-ish, I believe, I've grinded in a single day. And before you know it, you've been making like diagrams for 10 hours straight. And like you're going crazy and you need sleep. And that's why I recorded this intro. Anyways, with that said, let's get to it. Now, first things first, after having set up the account and receiving an ungodly amount of rewards, and I mean like an ungodly amount of rewards. Like, this was not even a third of the rewards. I swear to God, I've been sitting here for several minutes before I even started this recording. But once I had accepted all of this loot, the grind could finally begin. Oh my God, Jesus Christ, I said, once I had accepted all of this loot.
6.5 hours later.
Finally, I set out to get all of my characters to level 5. Why is that? Well, because you obtain a commendation chest every single time you level up a character, which you probably already knew. But the important thing to take away here is that when it comes to reaching 300 item power, the quantity of loot boxes is way more important than the quality of the loot boxes. This is because the quality of the box you are opening has absolutely no effect on the actual power of the items inside, with the only exception to this rule being the fact that strong boxes, which are obtained on recruit difficulty, have a power cap of exactly 100, which is reached fairly quickly, making it the only loot box in the game to become completely obsolete, which is why you always want to prioritize opening strong boxes regardless of the quality in the beginning. But before we move on with how to get to 300 item power as quickly as possible, let's first try to take a look at the crafting system, which, assuming you haven't modded your game, is gonna look something like this, which I'm sorry to say is not optimal, which is why I'm gonna enable my mod UI improvements, and I would suggest that anyone watching do the same, since it changes the outlook of the crafting system so that you have all menus available from a single window. Now, in a nutshell, the way the crafting system works is pretty straightforward. First, you have 4 buttons here, which will automatically move all items of a certain quality into the salvage items menu, which is the quickest way to salvage items you no longer have a use for. Then we have the craft item menu, which does exactly what you would think it does, which is to craft new items, which is something we'll get into in way more detail later on. Moving on, we got the reroll properties menu, which is something you should not be using until you reach an item power of 300, although I wouldn't bother to worry too much about it if you have been. But the logic here goes that you're gonna be able to reach 300 power fairly quickly with this technique, and thus there's no need for wasting dust on items that you're not going to keep anyways once you do reach 300 power, at which point you'll want to have as much of it as possible in order to reroll all of your favorite items. Then we have the upgrade menu, which for the cost of 10, 30, and 50 scrap respectively, will allow you to upgrade your items from white to green, from green to blue, and from blue to orange. At which point you will need 5 Bright Dust to upgrade the item to veteran quality. Bright Dust is only obtainable by disenchanting another red item and will automatically set the item power to 300, at which point you can reroll its properties with a guaranteed max value every time you reroll. Which brings us to applying illusions, which can be done free of charge. Once you have obtained an illusion, which can be done either by purchasing it from the shop or by the illusion dropping as a weapon, you are then able to apply it as many times as you want, and you don't need to worry about losing the actual item. The illusion will still be available in your inventory. And lastly, we got the dust converter, which is simply a tool used in case you have way too much orange or blue dust and not enough green or blue dust, allowing you to convert exactly 10 dust at a time so that you can once again reroll the properties of any given item. Now, just to recap and get an overview of the crafting system before we move on, let's try to take a look at this chart. Now, for the purposes of getting to 300 item power, the three most important items on this chart are scrap, salvaged weapon parts, and salvaged gem cutters toolkits. Now, scrap is used for both crafting weapons and crafting jewelry, as well as for upgrading your items, whereas salvaged weapon parts and salvaged gem cutters toolkits are each for crafting specific items, either weapons or jewelry, which is the exact same items that they are salvaged from. However, scrapping any given one item or piece of jewelry does not guarantee that it will drop neither a salvaged weapon part or a salvaged gem cutters toolkit. And from time to time throughout the process of getting to 300 item power, it will happen that you are low on either of these two crafting materials. But with that said, I think it's time to get to the meat and potatoes of this video and talk about the what, when, where, how, and why you can use this knowledge to your advantage when it comes to reaching 300 item power. So you may or may not have noticed this, but you do in fact have 5 items equipped at any given time. I know, we are truly exploring the very edges of vermin science, but stay with me here. Each of your 5 items have their own individual power metric associated with the item. An example of which could look like this: 105, 103, 102, 98, and 92 power respectively. But there's a problem here, and it lies in the distribution of the power. And in order to understand why there's a problem, first we have to calculate our overall average item power, which is a pretty straightforward addition of all of the power metrics, followed by a division by the amount of items we have equipped. And for the sake of simplicity, I've intentionally chosen a bunch of numbers that all neatly add up to 500, bringing our total average item power to a nice and neat number of 100. However, before we can move on with this newly obtained knowledge, first, we have to talk about something possibly potentially controversial, or at the very least, the single most surprising thing to me in the making of this video. You see, if we assume that the 5 items, the average item power of which all neatly added up to 100, were the 5 highest power items that the person had, well then that is going to affect the possible power distribution of items that you obtain in loot boxes. And when I researched this video, I was unable to find a single source that seemed to have this mechanic down to a science. But I do, however, think that I managed to figure it out on my own. You see, most people seem to think that any given item that drops in a loot box would be between minus 5 and plus 10 power in relation to your highest possible total average item power. However, I knew that this could not be the case, because during the recording of this video, I had already received an item that was as high as plus 15 power compared to my total highest average power. And so what I think I managed to figure out with about 95% certainty, I would say, is that the power distribution of items that are dropped in loot boxes in relationship to your total highest possible average item power seems to get smaller and smaller the higher up you get in power. This is why you feel that progress almost halts at a standstill once you reach 200 item power. Now, most of the uncertainty I have regarding this mechanic lies in the fact that I was unable to find any other source that claims this was the case, which obviously made me question myself. However, throughout a whole rise from 5 to roughly 250 item power, the rule showcased in this chart has held up. Now, on a last side note before we get back to how and why this is important for reaching 300 item power using crafting, I thought it was worth a mention that the level of the character you are on also affects whether or not you are able to obtain items of a certain quality from loot boxes. Now, I found several different posts that claimed that you could not obtain veteran quality items, aka red items, before you were level 25 on a given character. However, I seem to both recall and having heard of several different instances of people having obtained red quality items before reaching level 25. And when I asked around, several different people seemed to recall the same. But considering I was unable to obtain any verifiable proof of this, take it with a grain of salt. And let's get back to reaching 300 item power as quickly as possible. Now, where we last left off, we had concluded that our total average item power was equal to 100. This means that the items we could obtain through a chest would have a power differential of 15 going from minus 5 to plus 10. Now, what this means in practice is that considering our total average item power of 100, any given item that drops in a chest could be anywhere between 95 and 110, which of course also means that the average item power that should drop in a chest would be 102.5. Now, armed with this knowledge, let's try to take a look at what this actually means considering our previous power distribution in relationship to an equal but different power distribution that also adds up to a total average item power of exactly 100. Now, obviously, luck will always be a factor when we're talking about opening loot boxes, but statistically speaking, luck tends to average out over time. So let's imagine that all items that we open in said loot box is exactly equal to the average of 102.5. This means that for our top distribution, if we were to open either a ranged or melee weapon, you would not progress in your total average item power, whereas in the bottom distribution, you would progress in your total average item power. As for opening a necklace, half the time you would progress by one power and half the time you wouldn't. And in the case of both the charm and trinket in either distributions, you would progress your total average item power. In other words, we are statistically speaking more likely to make progress with the bottom power distribution as opposed to the top power distribution, despite the fact that the total power in either case is exactly equal to 500. But the observant motherfuckers among you might say, hold on a second, PK, because sure, you're more likely to make progress with the bottom distribution, but in any case where you do make progress on the top distribution by, for example, getting a trinket, the overall value of getting said trinket will be higher for the top distribution, and so the overall value in total should actually even out statistically speaking if you were to repeat the experiment enough times. To which I can only say yes. You'd be absolutely right. Statistically speaking, there would be no value difference between the two distributions. So what the hell have I been going on about for all this time, you might ask? Well, this is where crafting comes into the picture. You see, you may remember this chart from earlier, and it applies not only to items obtained through loot boxes, but also to items obtained through crafting. And there is only one of these two item distribution scenarios where we can categorically guarantee that the item we craft will have a higher power than the one we already have equipped. In other words, in the top distribution, we could just go ahead and craft a trinket, guaranteeing that we are going to obtain another trinket that will not only have a higher power than the one we currently have equipped, but also flatten out the distribution of our power, increasing the likelihood that the next chest we open will contain an item that will also increase our total average power. In other words, it's a win-win. So whenever you have an item with 5 less power than your total average item power, you should always go ahead and craft said item in order to even out your total power distribution. And lastly, before we move on, I do think it's also worth mentioning that I have tested out whether or not the game actually remembers the highest power item you've had in any given category. In other words, you don't need to worry about salvaging a higher power but lower quality item that you don't want to use, since you can simply craft a new one that will remember what the highest item power you've had in that category previously was. And with that said, I think it's time to move on to veteran item drop rates.
Can't complain about the drop rates. If you don't know, the drop rates.
Now, all the while talking about drop rates, I'm gonna play this annoying ass video that I've sped up 32 times of me going all the way from 5 item power to 220. So, drop rates. Where to start? Well, I think the first and most obvious thing to state is that higher qualities of chests obviously increase the likelihood of getting higher quality items. Now, there are two ways to increase the quality of the loot box you obtain. The first of which depends on the difficulty you are playing on, going all the way from strong boxes on recruit difficulty to vaults at legend difficulty. And secondly, you can try to obtain as many points as possible in any given game, in order to upgrade the quality of the loot box you obtain at the end. This is done by picking up tomes and grimoires, playing quick play, actually succeeding in the mission, obviously, since otherwise you're not even going to obtain a loot box in the first place, from picking up loot dye which can be found in boxes, dropping from loot rats or from killing lords and bosses, and lastly from always remembering to sacrifice the dwarf by pushing him into a pit of lava in order to incur favor with Renald.
Oi! Chase Grimnir's fury, Thagaraki!
Yeah, whatever, Barton, go away. Where was I? Oh yeah, drop rates. Now, keep in mind that I wasn't entirely sure whether or not there actually is a level cap at which you're unable to actually obtain red quality items. And I think it's also worth noting before I show you guys the chart I've made that no one actually knows the true drop rates, since all of this is calculated on Fat Shark servers. In other words, these are only estimates. Now, after having done a lot of research, and I mean a lot, the consensus was so unclear that I instead decided to make a chart showcasing the lowest and the highest estimated drop rates that had actual data behind them that I was able to find. And there are a couple of important things to note here. Now, one of the datasets that I was able to find was obtained by having a bunch of people open a bunch of chests and putting in the red item drop rates, whilst another one of these sets was made by a cheater who gave himself a bunch of legendary vaults and used that to estimate the drop rates. And even more importantly, I should also note that there was a significant change to the veteran item drop rate in a patch long, long ago, which is why it actually took me 200 hours play to ever obtain my first red quality item. You heard me right, 200 hours. For a period of time, I actually thought red items didn't exist and that someone had simply pranked me when they told me that they did. But in a patch, I believe pre-Winds of Magic, they significantly increased the drop rate of red items. But all of this was so long ago that I honestly don't know if any, both or either of the datasets were pre or post this quite significant patch which increased the drop rates. However, I do think that it makes sense due to the significant statistical differences in the two datasets to assume that most likely the low end of these drop rates were pre this patch and the high end of this spectrum were post this patch. But honestly, Fat Shark could have changed these drop rates at any given time and we wouldn't necessarily know. So these are simply my best estimates based off the data I could find on the internet, since I'm in no position to actually verify any of this myself. In other words, you should take all of these numbers with a grain of salt, since the most recent dataset I could find was still 2 years old. Anyways, that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, please like a comment and a subscribe so we can reach the 10,000. We're so close. But other than that, I hope you guys could use this info. I know for a lot of you guys, you probably already had a rough idea of how these mechanics worked, even if there were slight sort of differences. Most of you guys probably, you know, already knew how this worked. But I thought, again, that this was a nice and searchable video that would really help a lot of new players. And I think for a very long time, I've sort of been neglecting making videos for very new players. So I don't know, I just assumed that, I don't know, somewhere in my head, I was like, but there are no new players, right? everyone who's gonna play it has already started playing it. How many new players can there be? And you can't explain basic stuff, because what about all your viewers who already know that stuff? Like, you've already taught them a bunch of advanced stuff, so you can't tell them basic stuff now. I don't know why I was thinking like that, okay? Don't ask me. But anyways, regardless, I just hope you guys enjoyed today's video, learned something new. Hopefully you can apply it. If you have a friend who hasn't reached 300 item power yet, let him know. And as always, I love you guys. Stay awesome. Peace out.
Okay, Kenny, add Eyes of the Beast to your hotbar. Stan, check your fury talents to boost your shouts. Got it.